Thanks very much to Professor Alan Cowman, the Deputy Director here at Walter and Eliza Hall Institute, to Professor Carolyn Homer, the new Chair of the National Health and Medical Research Council, from the Burnet Institute, an expert in nursing and midwifery, and it's great, Caroline, to have you on board and to accept that role. And then to these amazing researchers here at Walter and Eliza Hall Institute. These are the sort of best and brightest emerging minds, established minds, people that are saving lives and protecting lives. And today is about saving lives and protecting lives. And on that note, I want to begin by just acknowledging the absolute joy and relief around the country at the finding of Cleo Smith, safe and well. Our police have done an amazing job. And to Cleo and her family, we're thrilled for you, and to our police in Western Australia and to all of those who've assisted in any way, shape and form, thank you. Thank you for everything you've done. But today's about our researchers, and in the last 20 months we've seen the impact and ravages of COVID. And we've understood perhaps more than ever how important the work of our medical researchers are, our doctors, our nurses, our pharmacists, our pathologists, in saving lives and protecting lives. And so I'm delighted to be here at the Walter and Eliza Hall Institute, a storied history dating back through great names like Sir Macfarlane Burnet and Sir Gustav Nossal, and then incredible people such as Dr. Ashley Davey that we've met today, Dr. Melinda Hardy that we've met today, who are leading research into cancer treatments and gluten treatments for people who suffer from gluten intolerance. So all the different parts, that tradition is being carried on here, and I'm delighted to announce, as part of the National Health and Medical Research Council Ideas Grants, 248 grants, $239 million, and supporting projects such as Ashley Davies' project with Dr. Melissa Call of breakthrough new cancer treatment, CAR-T, cellular immunotherapy. And they're focusing on leukemia and lymphoma, but then transferring this treatment for the first time to brain cancer and blood cancer, a new treatment for glioblastoma with an agonisingly low survival rate, which can potentially be elevated, trialled here in Melbourne across the road in a partnership between WEHI and Peter MacCallum to actually treat patients and save their lives. The work of Dr. Melinda Hardy and her team, there are 400,000 Australians with celiac disease, a particular form of gluten intolerance. Up to 15% of Australians have broad forms of gluten intolerance. So this is a widespread disease. It may not get the attention it deserves, but it's getting the funding it deserves. And so these grants are long-term grants, 4 years, to support our best and brightest researchers, people such as we see over here at WEHI, who've committed their careers to saving lives and protecting lives. And Caroline, as the new head of the NHMRC, is an incredible medical leader and advocate for medical research. Just beyond all of this, I want to note the progress in relation to the vaccine rollout. We've passed 36 million Australians who've been vaccinated, or 36 million vaccinations around the country. What that means is another 182,000 in the last 24 hours. We're at 36.2 million vaccinations, and we're at 88.9% of Australians, an extraordinary 88.9% of Australians that have had a first dose and 79.1% of Australians that have had a second dose. We will pass the double-dosed 80% rate in the coming few days, and that's a tribute to all of our researchers, all of our nurses, our doctors, our health professionals around the country. And to put a very bright note at the end of all of this, we've reached an extraordinary 99.4% first dose for over 70s. So if you haven't been vaccinated, join the club. Come and protect yourself. And if you've had a first dose and you're due for your second, please come forward. And if you're due for a booster, join the more than 100,000 Australians that in just a very short period have had their booster. So it's positive news on many fronts. And with that, I'm delighted to introduce for the first time with me as the new National Chair of the National Health and Medical Research Council, Professor Carolyn Homer. Carolyn.
Thank you, Minister, and what a pleasure it is. Thank you, Alan, for hosting this important event today. It's very exciting to be able to announce these grants. IDEAS grants are the second largest amount of money distributed by the NHNMRC and essential for research, but more importantly, as the Minister has said, essential for the health of Australians. And this work, the funds will support researchers, so hundreds of young researchers, particularly around the country, and we've had the privilege this morning of meeting two of them, who are doing just such important work. And these grants will now fund them for the next 4 to 5 years and really set them on their careers to make an enormous contribution to the health of Australians. It's a huge privilege to chair the NHNMRC Council, and I know that we have an incredible group of people, and we're going to work really hard for you, Minister, over the next 3 years to ensure that NHNMRC is strong and vibrant and resilient. And if I can just end on the happy note about the vaccines, absolutely delighted with the vaccine numbers, but I'm going to put a little call out there for pregnant women. So at the moment, while we have fantastic vaccination rates in many groups, pregnant women, and I'm a midwife, so this is an area very close to my heart, pregnant women are not getting vaccinated as the numbers that we would like to see. We have pregnant women in hospital in Victoria and in New South Wales, and some of them are very sick. And we know that if you get vaccinated when you're pregnant, you will not get sick of COVID if you catch the infection. So to all the pregnant women out there, please go and get vaccinated. It's absolutely critical, not only for you, but also for your baby and for your family. Thanks very much.